Greetings everyone. Today we have with us Mr. Shyam, and Mr. Shyam is from India, and he's done his master's in embedded systems in Germany, and right now he's working with Techem Energy Services in Germany as well. So Shyam, could you start off by telling something about yourself and your something about your background back in India?
Yeah, hello everyone. My name is Shyam Sundar. I come from India, southern part of India. City is Hassan. Mm-hmm. I am born on 20th September 1985 in Hassan. I did mm-hmm. my schooling and all my studies in Hassan, at Hassan. From Malnad, my engineering bachelor degree I did in computer science. It's mm-hmm. from Malnad College of Engineering, Hassan. So I completed my bachelor's in computer science in 2007. Mm-hmm. So during that time, during my course, I found some companies came to my campus. So I got selected to Wipro Technologies Limited, Bangalore, mm-hmm. During my studies. So I from the campus, and then I started working as a development engineer at Wipro headquarters in Electronic City, Bangalore. So I worked for 2 years, 7 months in Wipro. Mm-hmm. So I worked on basically in embedded systems in telecommunication domain mm-hmm. At Wipro. So I worked for 2.7 months, and during my career, I thought of initially during my bachelor's only, I had an idea of doing master's, but I did not know where I have to do it. So it was just a vague plan, like every student have during his bachelor course, because we hear or we see our seniors going to masters into US or somewhere else. So even I had the dream, let me also give it a try. So basically, masters is just a gateway to get a pass to get a job in a foreign country. So if you don't get on site, so I start during my Wipro time also. So I gave it a very deep thought, and I started working on achieving my dream. And so I decided to come to Germany for my master's.
Countries, let's say, like there are a plethora of countries that you can pursue uh-huh. a master's degree in. Like you have US, uh-huh. you have UK, you have Canada, you have Australia, you have Germany, you have all of Europe basically. So what actually compelled you to choose firstly embedded systems as a master's degree? And why did you choose Germany as a country to do your master's?
Yeah, first point I would say why Germany is financial, because the master's course in USA was costing a lot. Mm. So at that time, I was not able to afford so much money because you need to shell out a lot of money. Mm. So that was a financial way. And the second thing is, one of my family friend, he was working for Wipro, and he used to come more often to Germany for on-site. He was coming to some automobile companies and used to always tell me that courses in Germany are good and they are free or some basic cost, not so expensive like US. And one more advantage why Germany is, during your master's, you can work in proper company as a student and get some experience. Like since if you are a software engineer, you can work in a software company and get a software experience. And if you are a mechanical engineer, you can work in some automobile company and get an experience. And you can, so that is the main reason which compelled me to choose Germany over US. And one hurdle was the language. So that was the only challenge I had, to learn the language. So if I tame it, so I was good to go for Germany. So I did my German course before I came to Germany in Bangalore, Goethe Institute. I did A1 and A2 during my stay in Bangalore, during my work phase. And then I came to Germany in 2010. And why embedded system? Question. Because since my previous work experience in India was mainly or purely on telecom and this embedded Linux and embedded system or real-time things. So I chose embedded system. And also I had interest mainly to work on operating systems, Linux. So that's why I chose embedded system.
Okay, that's nice.
And why Paderborn? Because not only I applied actually for 5 universities. So I got acceptance from 2 universities, one from Paderborn, one from Heidelberg. But Heidelberg was more expensive, because when I came in 2010, Germany universities had a small nominal fees every semester. Okay. So Paderborn University's this nominal fee was on the lower side. So and also it's the best. It has the best scores or best ratings for computer science. Okay. And we also have the world's biggest computer museum here. So basically, it's a small Silicon Valley, you could say, Paderborn.
Now you said that you did in Paderborn University, you did your master's in embedded systems. So now, like usually, the two natural progression that any master's graduate sees is one is going into the industry and taking up a job after master's. The other is basically research in the same field in which you do your master's, right? So if you could elaborate on these two distinct and what compelled you as to choose industry as a line and not research as a line.
Before I answer this question, I want to say that before someone plans his career to Germany, so first thing is language, and second thing, they should do some groundwork based on what kind of educational institutions Germany have. Similarly, we have in India, we have a polytechnic, we have a bachelor degree course, and we also have IITs. So in Germany, we have Fachhochschule, which mainly concentrate on, it is like a polytechnic, it is mainly courses are job oriented.
Okay, it's applied courses.
So people, people who are, who always have their in their mind, they just want to do the job after master's, they should look for Fachhochschule, but they are always expensive because it always comes with a price, because they are not free, because most of them are private institutes. And second is Universitat, they call it, so where I did. Since this, if you choose Universitat or a technical university, which are like almost similar to IITs, I would not say same standard, because IITs are better than TUs. They are like similar. They don't only have TUs, only have a technical courses. And university has technical courses and also has different courses like music, arts and language courses. So if you join Universitat or technical university, then you will get an option whether to do a research after your master's or you can also find a job. But theories, courses in TU and Universitats are mainly not job oriented, they are mainly research oriented courses will be there. So you will be learning a lot of theory and random projects, but which are not job oriented, you will learn new things here. So I chose Universitat because I thought maybe I kept my options open. Who knows? If I don't find job at earliest, so I could have an option to start my research under some professor. Yeah, that's why I chose Universitat. But it depends. Again, you should be really clear when you start either Fachhochschule or Universitat. And you should make your mind to do research or not at least by the end of first semester, because then it need to be too
late. That comes on to the next question. After you decided that you wanted to get into industry and now you are actually working with SM Energy. So I just want to ask, how is it like to be actually working in Germany? Because like, I'm pretty sure that the working conditions in Germany as when you compare it to India is going to be in like n number of factors, right? So would you tell us what your overall experience actually about working in Germany after your master's?
So first and most important thing for any student or any foreign, or especially for Indian students who is coming from India to Germany, from Indian culture to German culture, first it is a cultural difference. Language barrier will be there, and second, all Germans are very hard working. I would say, like in India also, I work for a software company. People there are like a bit chilling, and there will be always one manager who always sits on you and who monitors what you want to do and when you have to deliver something. And there is no time limit. Like it's like you can chill and you'll work at a particular point of time, and you talk to colleagues, you go eat together, you do parties. But in Germany, it's a different culture. People are very closed. They are not so extrovert. And manager never just assigns you a task and gives you the deadline. So you have to just finish the task at that time. He will not come and poke you or ask you whether it is done. He will only check the status at the end of the deadline. So that's the one difference. And colleagues here, when you work in some company, you are just a colleague. You don't share some personal relations or something like in India. That's the one thing we have to get used to here. And the second thing is language, because since if you don't know the language, then you can't mingle here in a company, so you can't express yourself. like some big companies, maybe English will work out, but without the German, it was a bit hard for me also, because technically I learned everything in English, but I had to express these things in German. So initially I had hurdles when I started my job. So I started as a student, they call it a work student. I was in Fujitsu for 18 months.
Okay.
As a work student, I was in a quality assurance team in Fujitsu, where I did also my thesis. And then I shifted to another company for Comprion, which was basically working on a telecommunication product. So there I was student for 6 months, and then I got a full-time offer from my boss because he was happy with my job. And that's the one advantage for any student, because that they don't have in US, because here during my master's, if I join some company as a student, then there are high chances that company will absorb you at the end of your master course.
Okay.
So I had an opportunity there, so I worked in that company for 5 years, and then I shifted recently to the Tesham Energy Services. So one basic culture difference is the work environment. It's completely different. So you should be mentally prepared for that. You can't expect the same
time.
But India, you won't get time. But here they give you ample time to learn things before. So you have to use that time to learn things. Once you get a real task, you should be able to do it, because you would already have got a lot of time for learning things. So that's very important. And that's this is plus in Germany. This we miss in India. And minus would be the language. If you don't learn the language, then you can't go longer here. You can't survive for long here.
Like, my final question would be, like, let's say if there is any prospective student who is looking to do his master's in Germany.
So, I would say definitely yes. German market is good now. Maybe because of Corona, it is slow now. But I could see a lot of foreigners, especially Indians, coming for a job here from India with experience. But without experience also, one could try, but it would be harder. But one could do some certifications or trainings, and then he could apply directly from India or come for a job search visa. Yeah, the prospects are good. Automobile, not so great. They're not doing so great here during Corona's time. I'm not negative or degrading automobile, but currently market is not so good for automobile. But for computer science, really yes. For big data, cloud, and these things are hot topics now.
Okay.
Test automation, yeah. And one important thing is whoever from whatever branch, or whatever stream they come from, bachelor's or whatever. They should have one programming language knowledge, clear cut. If you are looking for testing, Python or some programming language is must. Or if you are coming for some from mechanical also, you should have knowledge of one programming language. It's very important in Germany.
That is to pursue masters in general or to pursue masters in a computer?
Masters in general, because let's say you start some masters in mechanical engineering, then you have to do some kind of simulation in CAD, or you have some projects which requires Python or something to simulate some things. So you need one programming language. It's always good to know one programming language before you start masters, because when we came, there were less Indians here. So even professors, we were new, we were from different culture, and they took some time to understand us, because Indians, we are different, right? Because in India, if you study bachelor's, you always know that when is your exam dates.
Yeah, that's
you true. Always know what subjects you have to study. But here, it's completely different. It's no spoon feeding here. You have to choose your subjects here. They just offer you the subjects and you say, I want to do this semester. And even you have to take your exam, you have to make an appointment if you want to give exam. Nobody will sit on you and say that you have to write exam on this day.
Okay.
So you have to be more independent than India here. So that's the one thing you have to quickly adapt to in Germany, independence, being independent here and make your own choices. So I would say it would be difficult earlier. Maybe I took a semester to get used to this. Maybe someone will do it faster, maybe someone requires more time, but you should be mentally really prepared to do masters. You should be mentally prepared that it will be hard. It's not so easy. It's not a cakewalk in Germany.
Okay.
It's fun, but you'll learn a lot of things. It's not a, not only about studies, it's about your how as an individual you will shape up here. You have to do your own work, you have to cook, you have to in conclusion, I would say you'll learn how to manage time.
Thank you so much, Sam. I think that was a pretty good conversation, and I think we covered a wide array of topics, right from, you know, masters to how culture impacts. The cultural impact of basically studying in Germany, as to how working in Germany is very interesting.
Yeah.
I really appreciate you talking about
us. If you'd like to consult Shyam or any other expert related to masters abroad or in specifically in Germany, then please do visit www.careerbanana.com. Also, tell us in the comment section below as to which course or which college abroad you would like us to cover.